This your boy Big Crit.
Yeah, you already know what it is, man.
What's happening, bro?
You not rocking with the chaotic vibes.
Yeah.
Of DJ CK.
On IndioRadio.com.
And the bad way to goddamn do this shit. Check, check, check. DJ CKI's Chaotic Vibes Podcast. I got my man Jabbo live in the motherfucking building. He's doing his 1-2 right now.
Cracking.
You already know what it is. Tuesday, motherfuckers. Tuesday, and we live, IndioRadio.com. Jabbo, introduce yourself, man. Tell him who you are, where you from.
It's the country kinfolk, your Alabama cousin, man. Birmingham, Alabama. Jabbo ENT, Complete Game Entertainment. You dig? BMLBG, saying all that shit, man. That's how we doing it.
Damn. So that one thing I wanted to say, like, what is the affiliation with BMG? Cause I know you and Sonny did the project together. Shout out to Sonny. Right.
Yeah, hell yeah.
Welcome home, Sonny, too.
Yeah, we finna do the second one. We finna do Free Game, too.
Yeah.
Like, we supposed to work on that bitch tomorrow.
Okay.
You did. But
exclusive shit.
How that shit came about, bro, was just out here ripping and running with the music and shit, running around. Of course, you know, Big Sean, and, you know, I was fucking with D at the time, you know what I'm saying? D and Sean was cool and shit, and Scooter was liking what I was doing, you know what I'm saying? He was like, I fuck with it, bro, you know what I'm saying? Like, pull up, let's get a record in, you know what I'm saying? I got the opportunity to do the record. We did the shit, and it was just like, the niggas around him kind of genuinely fuck with me. Like, you know, Pep and Sonny, you know what I'm saying? And shit, one day, me and Sonny was in the studio, and he came in, he wanted to do a record and shit, but they ain't had the cord for the nigga hard drive to plug the shit up. So we had TK Kravitz's little brother. I mean, big brother, one of them, you know what I'm saying? He came in, that motherfucker. He was like, bro, let me, I got some beats, let me play some beats for y'all and shit. So he played a beat that we did play with Pots. You know, Sonny did play with Pots, and shit came out so dope. It was just like, bro, we need to do a whole tape. You know what I'm saying? Like, cause shit, bro, we vibe, we did that off the dribble.
Yeah.
Just imagine that we just get in that bitch and lock in and shit, you know what I'm saying? And I really took Sonny serious as an artist, you feel me? Like, I don't think none of them niggas around him really took him serious as an artist. Like, but he knew that I fucked with him. You feel me? So he was like, I'm gonna fuck with Jab on this shit. You know what I'm saying? So shit, we did that, and that shit just brought me into the fold. And you know, like Dino and you know what I'm saying, Trouble. Like the whole game, bro. I fuck with everybody,
it's a whole
bro.
Bunch of them little motherfuckers
I fuck with the whole game, bro. You know what I'm saying? And I got the chance to meet Future and shit. That shit down to change my life, bro. Yeah. Like not even on no monetary or financial or no label shit. It was just like the shit he was just saying to the whole group that was in there. You know what I'm saying? We in the studio kicking shit. Big Bang Black was in there. You know what I'm saying? He chilling. So the niggas was exchanging stories and just, you know, just building. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like the guys say, well, they were building, bro.
They say meeting Future is like meeting the real wizard. Like the niggas.
Of course.
Quiet niggas, you kind of do his own
thing. But at the same time, I met the nigga when he was like on some talking shit.
Oh, okay.
Like he was on some. Bro, he was talking like he had the floor. You feel me?
Yeah.
Like I ain't meet him on the cool chilling back shit. I met him on when I came in. I heard him through when I first hit the door. You know, what I heard his voice talking. So he was saying some real shit. You know what I'm saying? That shit changed my life, bro. I ain't on any cap. You know what I'm saying? So
that's right. So you say you from Birmingham? We fuck around in Birmingham a little bit. Like, all right. So you know I'm from New York. I'm not even from Atlanta.
I ain't know that.
Yeah, I'm from New York. So, like, being in the South is one thing. Being in Birmingham is a whole different ballgame. Like, that's a different kind of South for me. That's a different kind of country for me.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So explain the difference between the big city and Birmingham and how that helped you shape who you are and, like, what kind of artist you became because of that.
Well, like, I mean, I came up on the west side of Birmingham, so I was in. I'm in the hood, so I didn't really like when people say like the country. I'm thinking like horses and shit like that. Like I ain't really see all that coming up until I went to my grandparents' house on my mom's side. They stayed like in the country, Shade Valley and shit like that. But my shit was like to get the hood. You know what I'm saying?
Like,
in the city,
like anywhere near Inslee.
Yeah, I'm West End, Riley. I'm right there, like West End, Riley, Inslee, Fairfield. I'm right there in that area, my fuck, bro. I'm right there in that area. So you know what I'm saying? It was like that coming up. And then we had black businesses on my block. You feel me? Like, Mr. Ben Thomas, he had the store at the end of the corner. He was black.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They ran buses to the casino and shit.
Yeah.
All that shit. Mr. Bill Brew, he owned like the first three houses on the block. So he was renting them out. And you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I just saw black businesses and black people thriving around me and shit. You know what I'm saying? But I was, you know, we was downtown. I saw city shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, I ain't really get too much of the country aspect until I went to my my mother's parents' house. But at the same time, man, it was just cool coming up, man, you know, going to school every day, seeing your friends and shit, doing right. shit in the neighborhood, playing basketball, messing with girls. Like, we did the typical shit.
Yeah.
Did it, so, you know, had a little weed, tried to smoke a little weed at, yeah, yeah. you know what I'm saying, 10, 11 years old, shit like that. You know what I'm saying? So we did the most, the common shit, man, and... my neighborhood was a GD neighborhood, though. You feel yeah. me? Like, one of no Bloods or Crips. It was just straight disciples. You yeah. know what I'm saying? So, and all my cousins was banging and shit. So, we saw all the shit that they was doing, too. You know what I'm saying? Oh, they was going on licks, coming home with piles of money. And, oh, you know what I'm saying? Oh, buying everybody Jordans and shit. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Shit like that. So
Real hood.
Yeah, yeah. Real hood shit. Yeah, yeah.
So the transition to Atlanta wasn't hard for you because it was already similar?
Oh, nah. Because all the hoods be the same in yeah. a way. It's just be different players. You know what I'm saying?
I guess when you're talking about the South, yeah. Because yeah. when it comes to the North, it's a lot different. It's a lot.
Of course. Definitely. Like, when I went to New York, you know what I'm saying? I did the record with Jadakiss, right?
Yeah.
So I got to go to the Yonkers and shit, yeah. go to D Block Studios. Yeah. And that shit was really like D Block. Yeah. Like, I went in that motherfucker, niggas was lifting weights and niggas was playing on the, like, the shit, no cap. Like, niggas, it was niggas in there working out, you know what I'm saying? It was yeah. niggas got down on the game, smoking weed, playing, talking shit loud, rolling dice and shit.
Yeah, yeah.
Jada was in there recording and shit, but it was like the typical, it was like what I thought D Block would look like. Mm-hmm. That's what it looked like. You feel me? Like, so I get it, you know what I'm saying? And another thing about the New York shit, I think y'all got a different bravado than we do down South. Because, like, down South, we dealt with, like, the slavery, civil rights shit. So we had to really stick together. That's yeah. why motherfuckers so nice down here to each other.
Yeah, yeah,
niggas be, you know what I'm saying, help, ready to help
different.
Out, woo-woo.
Yeah.
See, up there, everybody was free. Shit, it's like, nigga, I'm my name Freeman. So, yeah. shit, you stay up there, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm doing my thing. And
yeah.
it's like the concrete jungle. And, you know what I'm saying? So not saying it's wrong. It's just different.
I'm not going to say it's wrong. The competition is healthy, but... I think sometimes it might get a little bit out of hand, but you know how that shit go. Like, I don't know. It's something different. Like, that Southern hospitality is something different. I appreciate it. Fuck. I fuck with the South. Fuck that. And it get warm down here, man.
Everybody say that, though, man, because it's like, bro, what do you get out of not helping somebody?
That's a fact.
You know what I'm saying? That's how I look at this shit. What do you get out of not helping somebody? So if I see a motherfucker, you know what I'm saying, with a flat tire or something, nigga, I call AAA for you. If I got a jack, I might jack you up. You know what I'm saying?
That's crazy. Me and my business partner was stranded. What was that, like 2 weeks ago?
Nigga left y'all out there.
Nah, it's like, yo, like, they was helping us like they knew us like
yeah,
yesterday.
Yeah.
And like, that's what I'm saying. Like, in New York, like, I would have been out there. You know what I'm saying? I'd have probably got robbed. You know what I'm mm-hmm. saying? Like, but nah, like, they was helping us. Like, we literally sat there for like 2 hours. Everybody that stopped tried to help us.
Yeah, man.
Shout out to BMW for fucking that up, though. But
oh, yeah, you got to have them special lug wrenches and special jacks.
Like, the one I got don't even come with spare tires.
Oh, yeah, that's how I got one like that, too. No spare tire. And I ain't no tire. I was looking for the motherfucker.
Nigga, we was looking for
that. I was like, man, what the fuck? I see the battery and shit. What the fuck is this battery? Yeah, like, what's going on?
That's a fact. But nah, so
shout out to the rich nigga problem.
Yeah, I'm trying to tell you, god damn. I ain't no rich nigga though, bro.
Yeah, nigga.
Sponsorship's necessary, you dig?
Definitely.
Nah, let's talk about how you got into music though. How you got into the industry? How did that work out? What happened? What significantly changed?
Way back.
Many moons. Let's ride.
Yeah, all right. Well, like, music always kind of been in my DNA, bro. Like, my dad, he was like in the rock and roll shit. He was like a Jimi Hendrix type motherfucker. Yeah. He played all types of instruments and shit. So he was doing that, but by the time I was born, he had flipped over to the gospel.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So he was in church playing, you know what I'm saying? But the nigga is just musically talented anyway. My mom, she did a little singing here and there, you know what I'm saying? She passed, though. She died of lupus when I was like 13.
Sorry to hear.
You know what I'm saying? No problem, bro. Appreciate it. But what happened was, I just grew up around instruments and studio equipment and just shit all the time. So I just always saw this shit.
So you started out doing gospel?
No.
Oh, okay.
Hell no. Nah. I used to play the drums in church, though. Yeah, I was the drummer. I was the drummer in church, no cap. You know what I'm saying? Like, for many, many moons, bro.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, you got paid a good salary for that, man. Shout out to the churches
that pay the
drummers, G. Yeah, like, real talk.
Fuck that. But drummer always get some ass, too.
Yeah, definitely. But when I was about 15, man, like I told you, my mother passed.
Mm-hmm.
And then about 2 years after that, like, my dad, he kind of was doing his own thing, but he had a crib. on his own, but he had rooms for me and my sisters and shit. And so he had like the studio set up at the crib. So one day my homeboy, I always credit my nigga B Dawson, you know what I'm saying? He hit me, he was like, we was walking home from school, he was like, bro, ask your daddy, can I record a song? You know what I'm saying? So I'm like, shit, all right, cool, you know what I'm saying? And he was like, shit, you should rap too, bro. And I was like, nah, bro, I just want to be like the Babe, because Cash Money was hot that day. I was like, I don't want to be like the Babe of the shit, bro. I'm going to just sit back and bro, be Babe. Like, I'm going to let, I'm going to let y'all niggas do y'all thing, and you know, we'll figure it out.
Yeah.
But so we got in there and shit, and I end up fucking around, like laying some shit down. Nigga like, man, that shit hot. You know what I'm saying? And we was letting people hear this shit. They were like, bro, yo, you hot, bro. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So we did that. We even made a song for Valletta Flowers, like the first lady that won in the bobsled, won the Olympics or something. She was from Birmingham. Yeah, so we made a song with her. We was on the news and shit. Like, so I went to school. Like, we was in ninth grade. Nigga, I went to school. Nigga was like, bro, I seen you on the news rapping. I'm like, nah, bro, that wasn't me, bro. Because then nobody know we was getting down. You know what I'm saying? We was just sneaking, doing the shit. You know what I'm saying? Trying to be low-key with it. So, like, life kind of took over as far as, like, just, you know, sports and girls and, you know what I'm saying, you kind of fuck the music. Like, I'm playing basketball, I'm doing all types of shit. So come around to, like, 11th grade, I had got a job at this store called Trends Menswear in Birmingham, Alabama. It's in Western Hill Mall, you feel me? My manager at the time was this dude named Tamorg. I probably, like, 16, so he probably had to be, like, 24, 25, maybe 26. But the nigga was into the New York hip-hop scene like a motherfucker.
Yeah.
Like, so that's how I learned about all these artists like Joe Budden and Jay Hood and she. Like, I, because he used to get all the K-Slay tapes and DJ Clue tapes and shit. He was getting the throwback jerseys. And I knew about the Justo Awards, Rest in Peace of Justo. You know what I'm saying? So, like, I knew about all this shit. And he was burning CDs, so he used to be selling them out the store and shit, along with the clothes and the throwback jerseys and all that. So, you know, me seeing that shit, I was impressionable. I was like, bro, I want to sell CDs. So I started getting all these CDs and started exploring all these artists that I never probably would listen to. You know what I'm saying? And that kind of formed me into the rapper I am today. Just by being in my car, I had a whip, you know what I'm saying? I was 16 and shit. Just being in my car, riding around, listening to all these different records, just because I had them and I was going to sell them at school. But I started getting influenced by the shit, you know what I'm saying? Not indirectly, you know what I mean? So that did that. Then boom, fast forward to I turned 19. I went to college on a baseball scholarship at ASU. So still, I'm still like, nah, fuck the music. Like, I'm dibbling and dabbling. I'm, you know, writing a verse here though. So after my freshman year in college, I was gonna transfer back home to Miles. You know, Miles College in Birmingham.
I
was gonna transfer from ASU to Miles and shit, cause they were trying to offer me a little scholarship too. Cause me and the coach at ASU probably weren't clicking that good. You know what I'm saying? Like, we was cool.
Yeah.
Cause he was cool when he would recruit me and shit. You know what I'm saying? Then I signed this shit and I went down to the first year, was just like, ah, this shit alright. I don't really like this nigga. This nigga
switched up.
You know what I'm saying? He switched up a little bit. He cool though. Salute to him. You know what I'm saying? But anyway. Shout out to home. So anyway, I come home. My cousin like, hey, bro, I'm going to get you this little job at Buffalo Rock. You know what I'm saying? You driving the trucks and shit. You just stack your bread up till the school start again. Yeah. So this the summer and shit. So I come home, nigga, go take the drug test, pass that motherfucker by the grace of God. I don't know how I passed that bitch, bro. Like, nigga, because I know I had smoked the blunt going in the place down there, nigga. Like, but anyway, they the second day on the job, bro, I was coming home. I went around the corner to one of my partner's house. He was like, what you finna do? I was like, bro, I'ma go around and I gotta cut my other partner hair. I be cutting hands shit too.
Yeah.
So I like cut.
Got 100 hustles.
Yeah, man. Nigga had to just, you know, learn how to do a lot of shit, man. So the nigga, I was like, I gotta cut my partner hair because he graduated the next day. He was still in high school. You know what I'm saying? So he was finna graduate. I pull up at the house, man. And it's like two niggas walking down the street. But I ain't thinking nothing of it because, like I told you, we stay in the hood. So everybody pretty much know everybody. It ain't, I'm thinking it's two geekers or some shit.
Yeah.
How about the whip? Niggas draw down on me. You know what I'm saying? Like, get up, nigga. I'm like, what the fuck? So I ain't had my shit was in the car. You know what I'm saying? So I just took out running. Nigga shot me twice.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So I make it in the crib. And goddamn, you know, my grandmother, my granddaddy, he was still alive then. My daddy came, they scooped me up and shit. You know what I'm saying? They was praying over me, and the ambulance was coming. See, I took them niggas forever. Them niggas right at the fire department, right up the street. I'm like, where the fuck these niggas at? Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm laying on this bitch bleed. Got shot in the back and in the leg and shit. You know what I'm saying? But after that, I couldn't play baseball no more. I lost my scholarship and shit.
Yeah.
So it was like, fuck, what I'm going to do? So then I was just, I had kind of got in the streets like heavy. Like I started, cause I couldn't really work. Yeah. You know, I couldn't do shit. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
so
go get it out the mud.
Yeah. So I went back to school. I went back to ASU though.
Okay.
You dig? I went back to ASU and I started talking to one of the girls. She my wife now.
Okay.
And her, her brother-in-law, he had like a little studio and had like some little artists and shit he was working with. He was like, man, these little niggas, they got good flow. They just don't know what the fuck to say.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So he was like, could you come over here and, you know, write some shit for them? Went over there, I wrote some shit. And then he was like, bro, this shit fire. He was like, you should write some shit for you.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So I started fucking around with it, and that shit from that day forward, I ain't never stopped. Like that was like in 2007. And that's when I took it serious. Like after I got shot and shit, you know what I'm saying? I was like, man, let me go on, do some shit, bro, and get this shit right, bro.
That like the typical, not typical, but that like stereotypical story.
Yeah.
Like, you know, nigga got shot and he can't play sports no more, gotta get in these streets.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? But it's crazy.
It's like insert artists.
Yeah, exactly.
You know what I'm saying? Insert artists. Like,
exactly.
It is what it is, bro. Like,
but so you say you mad? Like, that's news to me. I didn't know.
I never
paid no thinking it's just jewelry to me.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I ain't even paying no attention to it. How is it being married in this industry? Because nigga, I'm in the strip club every day. And that shit is. I'm single, but it's like I couldn't even foresee how to balance the two.
Man, you gotta have.
You're an artist, so
you gotta have like the willpower, bro. Like for me, man, I don't think you should do this shit until you've done everything you wanted to do out here. Like as far as not, I ain't saying like financially or whatever, but as far as just fucking with hoes and out here ripping and running, doing shit. Like man, get that shit on out, bro. Go on, experience all your fantasies, everything you want to do, because what these people telling you is, nigga, this all the only ass you gonna fuck till you 80. That's what they telling you for the most part. That's what you signing up for. You know what I'm saying? This the only thing you can fuck until you 80 years old. That's basically what it is. So it's like, make sure you ready for that shit. You gotta really love that person. And you know what I'm saying? It's about compromise. Like the marriage is not about, it's about let me win sometime, then you can win sometime. You know what I'm saying? It's like you can't win every time. I can't win every time. You know what I'm saying? So it's like compromise, bro.
Yeah.
It's like, all right, she got me on this one. Fuck it.
Yeah.
Or she might be wrong on this one, but fuck it, I'm gonna let her have her day today. You know what I'm saying? So I can win in the long run. Yeah. I can win the next one when it really count. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
so
that's a hard way of thinking too.
Yeah, so that's how I look at the shit, bro. And you just gotta love who you with and know who you with, bro. Cause like some of these motherfuckers get married, they don't even be knowing these bitches for real, bro. Like, and I'm happy I met my wife like before Instagram.
Yeah.
Like Facebook had just came out, you know what I'm saying? Like before all that shit.
Bro,
you imagine how you know how hard it is to find a chick today with nigga, and when she post a picture and get 3,000 likes, so she already think nigga, hey, 3,000 motherfuckers want to fuck with me. So what the fuck you like? What the fuck?
Me,
because you know it ain't nothing but niggas liking this shit and hoes pretending to be gay. That's all that's on there, bro. Niggas and hoes pretending to be gay, bro. Like,
that's
real
a fact, though. That's a fact. That's a big fact. So shout out to Mrs. Jabbo.
My wife got a swimsuit line too. Let me plug her line real quick. Shayla J Swimwear, man. ShaylaJ.com, swimwear.com. You know, go get that. Follow at Shayla J Swimwear. Yeah, there it is.
That hard. So, before we had got on, we was talking about you being in the radio. How did that work out? Where did that come about?
What happened was, like I told you, when I went back to Alabama State.
Yeah.
I got my degree in radio and TV broadcasting. So I actually worked in television. I ain't working in radio.
We're not even going to pass by that. Like, you ain't just say you had a degree. Shout out to that. Like, not everybody. I don't even think everybody in this room got a degree. So,
man, it's all good. Shit, that shit just a piece of paper that sit in
the
house, dog.
But it's
don't even let me cap you down.
Nah, it's a discipline, too.
Oh, of course.
It's a discipline achievement. So, you know, shout out to that. Shout out to the degrees in the room.
Mm-hmm. But as I'm lighting this blunt, I'm gonna tell you, like, you know, I got that motherfucker, bro, and it's like I always be finding myself in unique situations, man. Like, when I went to, when I became a junior and I went to do my internship, right, I interned at WAKA CBS 8 news station in sports, feel me? So I'm down there for like a week, you know what I'm saying, interning and shit. These people offer me a job. I'm like, bro, I'm still in school. I don't know half of this shit. I'm a junior. I still got a whole nother year of school. People I'm in class with, they intern and talking about how they hate their shit, and they getting goddamn bad checks and shit. These people offer me a job. So I got the job. I took the shit. You feel me? So now I got leverage on my teachers. Yeah. I can tell my professors. I can tell them like, well, what y'all teaching, I'm getting paid to do anyway. Yeah. Like, I got to go clock in after I leave that class. So I don't even really need to come. Yeah. So I had some teachers that was like, oh, you already got a job. Like, you don't even need to come here. Just turn in, you know what I'm saying, whoop, and go about your business. You know what I'm saying? So I kind of finessed my way through the shit by getting a job. And that's by getting on. You know what I'm saying? In this shit, I took advantage of the opportunity. So that's why I always tell my young niggas, man, you see an opportunity, bro, that you can advance your career, take it. You know what I'm saying? Take that shit, bro.
Well, definitely. That shit crazy. Like, you know, I didn't necessarily go to school route, but at some point I still ended up behind the microphone and on the turntables and
exactly.
all that shit.
You ain't got to go to school.
Yeah, no, most
shit.
Definitely. Like, I tell people all the time, you know, I try not to discourage school, but I definitely tell people it's not the only way. You know what I'm saying? It ain't the only way to make this shit happen.
The best engineers I work with didn't go to school. Yeah. Some of the worst engineers I work with went to school. I graduated from here and here and like, nigga, you can barely fly the hook. Yeah. Like, man, get out of here. That shit, you know what I'm saying? Like, so school don't mean shit.
That
man.
Shit wishy washy. That shit in you, goddammit. Mm-hmm. But all right, man, let's get to some music, man. Let's talk about this My Little Nigga. Jabbo, My Little Nigga, produced by ATL Jacob.
My boy ATL Jacob.
Shout out to ATL Jacob. He come through. He's another one. He come in the club all the time. You know what I'm saying? Real low key tape shit.
Yeah, man.
But tell me a little something about the record.
Actually, man, that record came about. I was in 11th Street one day, and I was just kicking the shit. And my boy called me. He was telling me about my other partner who had he got caught in the dude house across the street fucking on the girl, dude girl while the dude was at work.
Yeah.
The dude came home with his cousin, my little partner, shot the dude and ran and was on the run. That's why I said my little nigga on the run for, you know what I'm saying? So it was just an organic record that just happened while I was in the studio. ATL, Jacob was there. He brought me some beats. I don't know if he made that beat or I already had it, but some kind of way I got the beat, you know what I'm saying? And we pulled that shit up, and I just rapped about what the nigga told me on the phone. Shit. Yeah. That was that.
So let's get into Jabbo, My Little Nigga, right quick. Right here, Chaotic Vibes Podcast, ndoradio.com. We will be right back. Jabbo in the motherfucking building.
Yeah.
ATL Jacob, ATL Jacob.
My little nigga on the run for a couple things. Some people come and ask questions, told